BBC Audio presents American Legacy, four gripping historical dramas by Mike Walker, centered around key figures who shaped America in the 20th century. In the first program in this collection, it's 1919. J. Edgar Hoover is in his mid-20s, and he's about to orchestrate America's first campaign against communism.
J. Edgar Hoover, Red Scare, with William Hootkins as J. Edgar Hoover.
Yes?
You asked to see me, sir? I'm John Hoover, sir, from the Alien Enemy Bureau, sir.
Ah, yes, yes. Sit down, Mr. Hoover.
Yes, sir, here?
No. Come over here.
Thanks, sir.
Well, you've been working with Mr. Bateman over at Justice, huh? Is that correct?
Yes, sir.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, let's see. Temporary War Division, registration of aliens. Yes, internment and parole of enemy aliens, issuing of permits, interned merchant sailors. Registration, Mr. Hoover?
Yes, it was felt that we should, the federal government, the authorities should have a full list and accounting of everyone who might be, a risk, sir, in wartime, sir.
You worked to John O'Brien?
Yes, sir, I was accredited special agent.
You ever actually arrested anyone, Mr. Hoover?
No, sir.
You have a stutter.
Used to have one, sir, as a child. I overcame it.
You recognize this?
No, sir, but I would assume that...
Yes,
that,
go ahead.
That is some sort of pipe bomb casing.
John O'Brien said you were a good man. Shrewd, he said. Didn't need a lexicon. Yes, this is part of a bomb, which blew the hands off a maid at the house of Senator Hardwick last week. It was left on the stoop. Anyone could have picked it up. A child, a mother, the maid. Poor girl.
Yes, sir.
Well, what do you think of that?
Think of that, sir? I think it is plain evil, sir.
Come over here, Mr. Hoover.
Yes, sir.
Washington is a small town. A small company town. Only the company happens to be the federal government. Your family are mostly government people?
Well, my uncle, my brother, yes, sir, most of them, I guess.
Mm-hmm. Your father?
He used to be. He used to work for the Cartographic Survey, maps. Mm-hmm. He used to joke that he was the one who drew the line around the United States that kept the bad people out and kept us all safe in our beds. Sorry, sir, I was just remembering.
Yes, and he's not well, I believe. He retired before the war, I hear.
Yes.
No pension, yes?
No.
Yeah, I guess that would be why you chose not to serve in the armed forces.
When I did my degree, sir, I worked days at the Library of Congress. Mr. Putnam was introducing the Dewey Decimal System. I worked in the day, and I...
Yes, and you worked at night.
Yes, sir, I never had any problem with working, sir. It seemed to me that if I may say...
Yes, go ahead.
If I might quote a stanza of Robert Service, "Only the strong shall thrive. Surely the weak shall perish, and only the fit survive."
Hmm. An uncompromising doctrine, Mr. Hoover. And did you apply it to your work at the Enemy Aliens Bureau?
So there were 1 million resident German aliens in this country in 1917. Any one of them, all of them, might have been working for the Kaiser. It was vital that they be cataloged.
Well, John O'Brien tells me you've built up the most complete system of files he'd ever seen.
Well, my experience at the library aided me in that.
Uh-huh. And now the war is over.
Yes, sir.
So... No more enemies, huh?
Well, sir, I think Senator Hardwick's maid might disagree with that.
I would disagree myself, Mr. Hoover. Last night, when I arrived home, I spotted the edge of a package protruding from under the stoop.
A bomb?
Yes. So you see, Mr. Hoover, the war is not over. The war goes on. But this time, we have a more deadly enemy. An enemy who thinks of nothing of killing, of diluting and polluting the minds of Americans so that they may bend them to their own ends. International socialism, so-called, quite simply intends the destruction of everything we've built up in this country since 1776. A new war, Hoover. A new call-up.
Yes, sir.
Now, I'm not talking about American unions here. No, they've quite clearly come out against any action that does not confine itself to economic improvement for their members. No. I'm talking about organizations like the International Workers of the World.
Oh, the Wobblies.
Yes. Well, they sound sort of homely when you call them Wobblies, don't they?
Yes.
But they don't sound so friendly when you consider that in February this year, over 6 million workers went on strike as a gesture of solidarity for the Seattle shipyard workers. 6.5 million. In March, there were 175 separate strikes. April, 248. May, 388. This country is under threat. These people want to see a Bolshevik state right here.
What do you need, sir?
Well, sit down, Hoover. Now, I would like you to transfer from Justice to the Bureau of Investigation and head up that operation. If you accept, you will receive a promotion to the rank of Special Assistant to the Attorney General.
There is, if I might put forward a possible objection, sir.
Yes, go ahead.
Well, my age, sir.
You're 24. Oh, granted, you're young, and you may have to deal with men a great deal older than yourself. Are you concerned about that?
No, sir, I am not. I thought you might be.
No, sir, I am not. I think you'll do very well for us, Mr. Hoover. Yes. Yes, very well indeed.
Then I accept.
Welcome aboard.
Good evening, Mother.
I'm through here, Edgar, dear.
Of course you are, Mother. You're always in here when I get home.
I know how you like things to be consistent.
You know me very well, Mother. However, you cannot seem to remember that I don't like the blinds to be pulled this early in the afternoon. After all, Mother, why waste the afternoon sun?
That is all very well for you to say, Edgar, but sunlight will fade the colors of the furniture. It'll bleach them right out.
Well, perhaps then we should compromise.
May I pour you a cup of tea, Edgar?
Thank you, Mother, and settle on all white furniture.
Think of the expanse, and with your poor father.
I spoke by way of a joke, Mother. However, if we should decide to buy new furniture, it would not prove too much of a burden, financially.
Some cake?
Thank you.
You have been promoted, Edgar?
I have a new job. I saw the Attorney General, Mr. A. Mitchell Palmer, today. He offered me a job as Special Assistant.
Oh, Edgar, my wonderful darling boy, you are so clever. Didn't I always say so? Now give me a big kiss.
Yes.
So clever. And will this mean an increase in your salary?
$3,000 a year, Mother.
My lord. My lord, I don't think your poor father ever earned that in. But I do not know that I would care for new furniture. What we have now seems quite adequate to our needs.
Of course it does, Mother. This is very fine cake.
Belle made it.
She has a way with baking.
I'm afraid that's not all she has a way with, Edgar. I had to talk to her again today. Her work about the house is less than satisfactory. I said to her, Belle, here is dust under the lintel, dust under the fronts of the chairs.
Yes.
The stairs carpet is less than satisfactory.
I hope things were settled amicably, Mother. I should hate to lose a cake baker of this talent.
I fear you may have to, Edgar. I'm thinking of putting her off.
Mother.
You know the way she looks at you with that... I can only describe it as Negro insolence, that closed face, as if she's thinking something that she cannot say to my face.
I am concerned, Mother. You must have run through every housekeeper in Washington.
Oh, no, dear. There's always labor available. There are so many of them down there in Darktown. They have such big families.
Well, I guess it keeps them busy.
Edgar, really?
Excuse me, Mother. I was being facetious. I apologize. Though I have to say that the thought had occurred to me.
Another cup of tea?
No, thank you. I must go up. I have a lot of work to do.
You work too hard, Edgar.
Mother, I really do believe a fellow cannot work too hard.
I remember you before college debates. Why, you'd be up there going over and over.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.